In 1969, Neil Armstrong, Edwin Buzz Aldrin, and Michael Collins embarked on a pioneering and epic mission. But the story of Apollo 11 begins long before the moon landing, with years of hard work, innovation, and determination to overcome tragedies, accidents, technological, and financial challenges. So I would like to present in this video something almost made Apollo 11 a major space disaster. But before we begin, I need to ask you to consider subscribing to the channel. Every week I bring quality content. And who knows, this content might open a small door to an infinite universe of knowledge. Your act of subscribing can also contribute to this content being seen by thousands and maybe millions of people. So I count on your help. The Apollo program faced many difficulties, including the tragedy of Apollo 1, where three astronauts, Virgil Gus Grissom, Edward H. White II, and Roger B. Chaffee, died during a ground test on the launch pad in 1967. During the test, a fire broke out in the Apollo 1 capsule, which was pressurized with an atmosphere of pure oxygen. The rapid spread of flames prevented the astronauts from escaping the capsule, resulting in their deaths. The accident was attributed to a series of failures, including problems with the design of the capsule and the flammability of the pure oxygen environment. During the crew's attempt to exit the command module, Grissom radioed that there was a fire in the cockpit due to a short circuit inside the cabin. This tragedy resulted in a 20-month hiatus in the project and significant changes in NASA's safety culture, which became more stringent and committed to ensuring astronaut safety. In another accident that occurred in May 1968, during a lunar landing training, Neil Armstrong lost control of the Lunar Landing Research Vehicle, LLRV, and it went into a spin. Armstrong was able to eject safely. However, subsequent analyses concluded that his parachute would not have opened in time if he had ejected half a second later. His only injury was a bitten tongue and some bruises, while the Lunar Landing Research Vehicle was completely destroyed. On December 23rd of the same year, Armstrong was invited by Donald Kent, Deke Slayton, to be the commander of the historic mission. The entire crew was officially announced on January 9th, 1969. The launch of Apollo 11 took place on July 16th, 1969, at Kennedy Space Center in Florida. It was a historic day for space exploration, as it was the first time humans would attempt to land on the moon. The launch was scheduled for 9 hours and 32 minutes, and thousands of people gathered to watch it live. The crew, Neil Armstrong, Edwin Buzz Aldrin, and Michael Collins, had spent months training for the mission, and tension was high as they prepared to embark on this dangerous journey. The launch went smoothly, and the spacecraft entered Earth's orbit approximately 12 minutes later. The mission control team in Houston, Texas, communicated with the crew, monitoring every step of the mission to ensure the astronauts' safety. As the spacecraft traveled towards the moon, the crew performed various maneuvers to adjust its trajectory and prepare for the moon landing. It was a tense moment for everyone involved. The first issue faced by the team occurred after Armstrong realized, shortly after the start of the descent, that the Lunar Module Eagle would land kilometers beyond the planned zone. Several computer error alarms appeared as the Eagle's landing radar analyzed the surface. Armstrong and Aldrin, despite their hours of training, did not know what these alarms meant. They were informed by Charles Duke, the Capcom, that none of the alarms were concerning. They were being caused by an overload in the Lunar Module's computer. Aldrin later described that the overload occurred due to his choice to leave the docking radar running during the lunar landing process, so the computer had to process unnecessary radar data and didn't have enough time to execute all tasks, abandoning low-priority ones. Aldrin stated that he did this in order to facilitate a docking with the command module, in case the mission needed to be aborted, without realizing it would cause an overload. After the tragedy of Apollo 1, Armstrong's accident during training, and now, the computer overload failures in the Lunar Module Eagle. Other problems almost prevented the success of the Apollo 11 mission. During the landing, the Lunar Module Eagle was heading towards a very rough region, full of rocks and craters. With mission controls concerned that the lunar module could run out of fuel, Armstrong made the decision to abort the landing maneuver and switch to a safer area, showcasing his skills as a test pilot. He was known for his ability to manually control the spacecraft, which was crucial for the lunar landing and navigation during the moonwalk. Post-mission analyses showed that the landing occurred with only 45 to 50 seconds of fuel remaining for burn. Michael Collins, the command module pilot, was responsible for keeping the spacecraft in lunar orbit while Armstrong and Aldrin were on the moon's surface. His maneuvering skills were crucial for the safe return of the crew to Earth. Despite the difficulties, the crew remained focused and determined. And at 2 hours and 56 minutes on July 21, 1969, Neil Armstrong became the first human to set foot on the moon, uttering his famous words,
"It's one small step for man, one giant leap for mankind."
However, the next step almost jeopardized everything. After returning to the Lunar Module Eagle, the hatch was closed and sealed. Armstrong and Aldrin discovered during preparations for liftoff that they had accidentally broken the ignition switch for the ascent engine while wearing their spacesuits. They then used a pen to push the breaker and activate the launch sequence. It may seem like a simple thing, but imagine that the astronauts were 238,900 miles away from planet Earth and had very limited resources to solve unforeseen issues like this. For NASA, the chances of a successful mission were 90%. However, Neil Armstrong once said that for him, the chances were practically the same, meaning 50%. Armstrong also said, open quote, "Most people don't realize how difficult the mission was," close quote. That's why each of them played a crucial role in solving the challenges faced, and the success of the Apollo 11 mission would not have been possible without the collaboration and teamwork of the crew, along with the support of NASA. All the research and work put into creating a video like this can easily be repaid. So, please click the like button. When you show that the content was helpful to you, it recharges our batteries to continue our project of creating an online learning community. It also helps to share the content with even more people.
I therefore ask the Congress, above and beyond the increases I have earlier requested for space activities, to provide the funds which are needed to meet the following national goals. First, I believe that this nation should commit itself to achieving the goal before this decade is out of landing a man on the moon and returning him safely to the Earth. No single space project in this period will be more impressive to mankind or more important for the long-range exploration of space, and none will be so difficult or expensive to accomplish.
The 1969 moon landing was a historic moment that inspired and will continue to inspire future generations to explore the universe and seek new horizons. The Apollo 11 mission is a reminder of the human capacity to overcome seemingly impossible challenges and achieve great accomplishments. Neil Armstrong, Buzz Aldrin, and Michael Collins played pivotal roles in the mission, facing technical, physical, and emotional challenges to achieve success. Now it's up to you. I need you to tell me in the comments which topics related to the channel's theme you would like to watch here, and also if you know of any other situations that I didn't mention here that could have jeopardized the Apollo 11 mission. And if you know someone else who is also passionate about space travel, share this video and be part of the growth of our community. I'm going to leave an amazing video about this great genius of humanity on the screen. I'll also leave this playlist that I'm sure you'll enjoy. I'm very grateful for you reaching this far, and I'll see you in the next video.